Dragon Hill under the sun, and a horse in the shade. The horse is thought to be at least 3,000 years old. They've got their wool on. Looking back towards the castle, the latest White Hart stage. This slip should disappear after the project. There's a new bridge over the main line with a new slip onto this road further on. The new slip lane should be around here, albeit with a steepish gradient onto it from the revised junction. There should be around 200 metres on the level to accelerate. Should be better than joining from Merlin Way roundabout. New junction. Hay Lane to off-road. The new road peels to the left onto off-road. The right turn is onto Hay Lane. A roundabout with no name. Via Rawton to Hackpen Hill. The new layout again. There's the old road to the left. Happy New Year, and here's a layout where no one's map is up to date yet. There used to be a slip here, but now it's an extra lane, 750 metres long, during which east-west traffic needs to negotiate. The main one does not have to give way at the roundabout, but the second lane could also be used if someone screwed up the lane choice further north. It was 12 degrees today, and the grass is still growing a bit. The sheep are grazing. Around the castle, a warehouse full of grit and salt, no doubt, given the weather so far this winter. The slip is still open. Thank you. Light wind today. And a close look at the horse. Moles underground. It's a steep climb. Look how shallow the soil is here. Spot the spelling error. Sown last autumn, looks quite healthy. The remains of this dead tree are still here. Useful to sit on while having a snack. Turning round here. These solar panels no doubt feed the cash machine in the car park.
Enter the roundabout, take the first exit.
No, I won't. I'll take the second. The sat-nav is desperate to maximise the use of A-roads en route.
Recalculating route. After 200 yards, turn right.
Which would route me back onto the one I don't want to use, so I'll turn left here.
Take the next right. Recalculating route.
The Freak was a conventional pub, but is now trading as a restaurant. Doing all right looking at the car park. Not as bad as some places. No leaves on the trees. Later on, clumps of lichen from the roof. The garlic is growing, but the broad beans have been knocked about a bit. The fruit trees are standing, and Lord Derby has his flower buds on this year. Some houses have fence panels knocked down. An oil field, in effect. It's been a mild winter, warmer than average. No snow at all this time, and not too much rain.